There are other things. There's subtle things going on, of course. IGF, of course. Just to bring it back to where we were. IGF is really interesting because centrally and peripherally, you may actually want them to be in opposite directions. Right. You probably know this, but Amgen had a drug that was an IGF receptor antibody. It went into clinical trials, phase two trials, in pancreatic cancer, advanced pancreatic cancer, and it failed. Now, it failed despite reducing IGF levels at the receptor by 50%. You could argue that that failure implies that reducing IGF is irrelevant. Reducing IGF is irrelevant once the tumor burden is established. Reducing IGF to only 55% is irrelevant. You could argue 100 different things. But what's most interesting is that antibody does not cross the blood-brain barrier. And so today, there is ongoing research, it's all in animals at this point in time, that's looking at giving a diet that actually increases IGF, but giving it in the presence of this IGF receptor antibody. The point being is, can we raise IGF levels totally, primarily centrally, and then block the receptor peripherally? So we ward off cancer and diabetes, but we ward off dementia. And actually, there's even evidence, though I think this evidence isn't as strong, that elevated levels of central IGF also are protective against diabetes.
Oh, really?
Yeah. But again, the problem is these are animal data, so you got to sort of take everything with like a lot of speculation.